Welcome back, students. Let's recall for whatever we have studied in this lesson, the living world, adaptation and classification. In the beginning, we came to know what is adaptation. Gradual changes occur in the body parts and also in the behavior of organisms, which help them to adjust to their surroundings. Such changes are called adaptation. They take place over a long period of time. In this lesson, we have come to know different types of plants and different types of animals. Plants and animals live in different areas in different regions. Some live in desert, some live in water, some live in snowy region, some live in forest. Some are small, some are large, and some are very minute in their size. These plants and animals are adapted due to the areas, the region in which they live. In this lesson, we have studied different adaptations in plants like adaptation in aquatic plants, adaptation in desert plants, adaptation in plants of snowy region, adaptation in plants of forest region, adaptation in grassland plants, and adaptation for ingestion of food in plants. Later on, in today's class, we have studied adaptation in animals. Animals are basically of two types, terrestrial and aquatic. Terrestrial animals are the animals which live on land, and aquatic animals are animals which live in water. What about aerial animals? Animals which are able to fly like birds are the aerial animals. So we have studied about adaptation in forest and grassland animals, adaptation in desert animals, adaptation in animals of snowy region, adaptation in aerial animals, adaptation in reptiles, adaptation for food in animals, and adaptation for blending with the surrounding. And lastly, we have studied about the classification of living organisms. Living organisms are classified under the two categories, plants and animals. Their hierarchy is as follows: kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, and species. This is called the hierarchy of classification, which was displayed by Charles Darwin, the scientist who gave the theory of survival of the fittest. The last point of this lesson is binomial nomenclature by Carl Linnaeus, who displayed that binomial nomenclature is used to identify each organism. It also says that every living organism has its biological name, of which the first part is called its genus and the second part is called its species. Thank you.